Look, I'm sorry to disturb you and everything. Mr. Van Staten might think he's clever, but never mind him. I've come to talk and review you. I'm Nicholas Payne, you may call me Nick.
Payne?
Impossible.
Nicholas! Nick! Payne! Exterminate! You are a prisoner of the Daleks! You must be destroyed! Why is my voice not working? Oh, I don't feel so good at the moment.
Hello ladies and gentlemen, Nick here, and welcome to my review of Doctor Who Series 1 Episode 6, Dalek. The first Doctor Who story of the new series to feature the return of the Daleks. Yay! Dalek voice is usually better than that. Okay, so Dalek. The plot of this story sees the Doctor and Rose arrive in an underground alien museum run by Mr. Henry Van Staten, who is a genius, supposedly, and a very rich and pompous one at that, and pretty evil. Well, I say evil, he's definitely a villain of some sort. Anyway, so the Doctor and Rose are captured by his guards and they're going to see Mr. Van Staten. He reveals that he has a living alien creature down in the vaults, and he takes the Doctor down to see it. It turns out that this alien creature is in fact a Dalek. And we probably have the best scene of the entire show at this point in this, at this point when the Doctor sees the Dalek for the first time. It's just masterful. Look at the way it's shot, look at the way it's performed. It's amazing. The Doctor's pretty much begging to get out. If it was any other Doctor, I don't think he'd be that scared to be... I mean, they would be scared, they would be begging to be left out. But the way Christopher Eccleston is doing it, it's amazing. And then the way that they're laughing at the Dalek for not being able to kill them. Oh, that's so good. And then it's revealed that the Daleks were the ones the Doctor fought in the Time War. As we could probably assume from End of the World, but it's confirmed here. And you can definitely tell the Doctor and the Dalek just completely despise each other in the scene. But at the same time, they have regrets over the war. Christopher Eccleston's performance here is just amazing, and he continues to have an amazing performance throughout the story as he and the Dalek have other sort of clashes with each other, emotional clashes. Just absolutely masterful. Absolutely masterful performance acting from Christopher Eccleston. This is probably why he or Peter Capaldi are the best actors to play the Doctor. I'll get to Capaldi when I get to his stories, but Eccleston's performance just bursts through and shines out on everybody. It's amazing. The other great moments see him when he's talking to the Dalek on the screen. Another fantastic moment when he's talking to the Dalek. Don't you see it's all gone? Everything you were, everything you stood for. And then pretty much orders the Dalek to kill itself. Which the Dalek responds with, "You would make a good Dalek." Later on, it also used the Dalek uses the Doctor's feelings, manipulates the Doctor's feelings to set itself free. Otherwise, it will kill Rose properly this time. And then at the very end, we've got the Doctor prepared to kill the Dalek once and for all, whilst it just wants the sunlight. That is a great scene. As we're kind of seeing. The Doctor starting to become the Dalek, although he does have the right to destroy the Dalek after everything they've done, not just the Time War. Don't forget all the bad stuff they did in the classic series. But it's quite interesting to see the Doctor becoming sort of a Dalek-esque creature, even if he's sort of in the right. Of course, the Doctor, being the Doctor, he still has his morals and still understands. Plus, the Dalek kills itself anyway. In a pretty emotional scene, the Dalek is a pretty emotional character in this story. I think it must manipulate Rose into setting it free by touching it. It must be manipulating her. It must know and manipulate her. Because otherwise, why is it acting that way? Because that it would be out of character for a Dalek. Even if it was dying, it still had one trick up its sleeve, or sucker. Unless it pretty much has completely given up. And then at the very end, it pretty much does give up. As it realises the emotions and the feelings that Rose has given it. To quote it from earlier, "You have contaminated me! You gave me life! What else did you give me?" So it's kind of got some sort of the human emotions and feelings in her. So I think the Doctor said it's absorbed part of her DNA. Something which the Dalek can't accept and decides to destroy itself in a very interesting way. Usually Daleks that destroy themselves just blow up, see a sign of the Daleks, and or they just shout, "I have failed, I have failed," etc., and just terminate their lives and just stop. I think that's what happened. I don't know which one it was. It was either Planet of the Daleks or Death to the Daleks. It was one of those two. I think it was Death. It just went, "I have failed, I have failed, I have failed," and just killed itself. I don't know if it blew up, but I think it just died. Yeah, I think what we get here is a very interesting new way of a Dalek self-destructing with the ball, with it hovering into the air. We'll get back to that in a bit. And the baubles coming out around the centre globes. And then they circle the Dalek and then cause a blue light and then it blows itself up. It's a very interesting way. And there's no debris left. It's all gone. And I actually think the Doctor's kind of a bit sad at the end of this. Or at least he has this kind of saddened emotions. Because it was the last one. And he did try to kill it. And he's now seen the how its new feelings, as well as his understanding that the Dalek would rather accept death than be anything different than a normal Dalek. And the bit where Rose has to order the Dalek to kill itself, that is actually quite a struggle. Oh, this is such an emotional story for our main characters and our main villain. And yeah, it's brilliant. I also love how we got kind of two Dalek designs. It's a brand new bronze Dalek design, which in the Russell T Davies era looks absolutely beautiful, especially in this story. They're just so amazing. It's by the time we get to the Stephen Moffat era, it does start to look a bit dull, at least the one that pops up there. Though they have the nice new coat of paint for the other two bronze Daleks that go kiki for camouflage, but the bronze Dalek just looks a bit dull. The one bronze Dalek looks a bit dull in that setting. I don't know what it is. So it felt good to introduce the new Dalek range. They looked a little bit better in the Sign of the Daleks. Well, the ones in the spaceship, and it made sense for being in Day of the Doctor. But I think come 2019, when we've pretty much had bronze Daleks in nearly every Dalek story since 2005, I say nearly, because the Paradigm Daleks did pop up in Series 5's finale, and we've had the new Reconnaissance Dalek from Resolution. But pretty much every other story, and the majority of other cameos, it's been the bronze Daleks. So I think it's about time we're going to need a new design, Chris Chibnall, come 2020, 2021, 22. I did say I think they should skip Series 12, maybe Series 13. Come back in 2021 with a new design. Maybe in the finale. But anyway, in 2005, the bronze Daleks, wow, these were amazing. And they look more metallic than before, and they just look amazing. The Dalek design could be considered outdated since the 1970s, to quote Mr. TARDIS Reviews review. And like I said in Destiny of the Daleks, I think that story pretty much made the Daleks a joke. I know some people would say the chase, but I think the Daleks were made a joke in Destiny of the Daleks. And I think no matter how good the 80s Dalek stories tried to be, especially Remembrance, they could not save the Daleks' reputation that probably scorned their species in the late 70s, maybe even as far back as Genesis, even though that did the Daleks justice. Maybe the earlier 70s Dalek stories maybe have tarnished their legacy a little bit, but it was definitely Destiny that ruined it. And no matter how much the 80s stories tried to fix that, they did not succeed. But but the new series one-ups some classic series by creating probably the best Dalek ever. Well, besides the special weapons Dalek, of course, but the best normal Dalek, the best Dalek soldier, by introducing this brand new bronze Dalek. And it, like I said, it looks beautiful and it's super powerful. And once it escapes the cage, it goes on a killing spree. I'll talk more about that first, but we've also got the Dalek casing where it looks really damaged. I'm guessing they built two props because you've got that one and you've got the brand new Dalek that takes over. But yeah, the damaged prop looks really great. Shirt certainly shows a damaged Daleks in the war, crashing to Earth and being a prisoner of private collectors for 50 years. And yeah, it definitely looks worn out and definitely looks dying. Great, great stuff. And then when it escapes and absorbs, downloads the internet, it repairs itself and it looks fucking gorgeous. It looks amazing. And then it goes on a killing spree. And my God, this is a fantastic Dalek. This Dalek's super. But wait, stairs. Daleks can't go up the staircase. Well, actually, remember, it's the Daleks. We saw them hover up the stairs. But even then, you could argue that was some sort of hover device, although it does look like it is actually flying. And Revelation, we sort of see a Dalek flying, sort of. But this story 100% confirms that by 2005, the Daleks do fly with hover and stuff underneath, instead of having to have this hovery thing or spaceships in the sky. Daleks can fly. And they will continue to fly. So now running up the staircases is no longer a problem. Remember in Death of the Daleks when the Doctor says, if you're the most powerful beings in the universe, why don't you climb up after us? Bye bye, sir. And the Dalek just shoots him just as soon as he moves his head, which, by the way, bad timing by the Dalek. Here, the Dalek could probably roll underneath the space on top and then fly up and exterminate the Doctor straight on. So yeah, this again baits Destiny of the Daleks by doing that. Oh, it's amazing. This story is way better than Destiny of the Daleks, by the way. So it's just this is outstanding. And I love the way the Dalek questions itself later on when it fails to kill Rose and it doesn't kill Van Staten on her request. Just so amazing. Not to mention outstanding, no, definitive Dalek voices from Nicholas Briggs. He is the god of all Dalek voices. Worship him. Worship him. Worship him. In all seriousness, he is awesome. He is probably the best Dalek voices ever. And it's outstanding. And I'm glad that he continues to be the voice of the Daleks, as well as other monsters and creatures in the new series, as well as at Big Finish. Yay! Right, back to Nick with the rest of this review. Right, that's the main portion of the story out of the way with the Dalek. What's the rest of the story like? Well, we've also got Henry Van Staten, who's a pretty good villain slash person in the room. And we've also got Diana Goddard, the surname named after writer Robert Sherman's wife, Jane Goddard. And I think she's a very good character as well. And very, very pretty. And the actress certainly does a very good job in the role. And I like how she becomes in charge at the very end. And pretty much orders Van Staten's dismissal. Yeah, she's a good character. Adam Mitchell, played by Bruno Langley. Okay. I think he's an okay supporting character. I think the actor does a good job. But he becomes a companion at the end, which is more of a problem with the next story. But I don't think he's that great. I think he's okay of a character, but I don't think he's companion material. I think if he went through a growth in this story, he probably would be. He's just brought on board, more or less. Yeah, it wouldn't be so bad if he was a companion. I think he'd be okay just as a regular supporting character. I'd rather have Goddard as a companion, actually. She actually had some character growth throughout the story. Adam just stayed pretty much the same. We got some decent backstory to him, but again, could have worked for a supporting character just as well. And as for the other, we've also got Simmons, who's the guy who tortures the creature, and he gets pretty much his skull crushed. Yeah, this story is rated 12, mainly due to the Doctor torturing the Dalek in one bit, but you've also got quite a few Dalek and Doctor torture scenes on each other. Some scenes torturing the Daleks by Simmons, and some scenes torturing the Doctor by Van Staten. Not to mention all the Dalek merciless murdering, and of course crushing the skull. So yeah, I actually can see why this episode's a 12. It's the last one before Tooth and Claw, though. So the rest of the series is a PG in the UK. In Ireland, there's at least one or two. In Ireland, there's at least one episode between episodes 7 and 10. And also, we've got a couple of guards who are pretty good. There's this, I think it's Pendansky or something, taking on the Dalek. He gets killed. I think he's the Dalek's first victim with its gun. And we've also got this lady soldier who helps Adam and Rose. She has a pretty good bit before she dies. Though her death is, it turns out to be for nothing, as she dies and Adam and Rose is still on the run. And then you got all these people lining up to shoot the Dalek when it comes through this one area, and it shows off by flying into the air, shooting the waters, the sprinkler system, and shooting the people down below, and everyone gets electrocuted, and then it fires upwards and everybody else gets electrocuted. By the way, one of the soldiers up there, he listens to advice from the Doctor, but he says, "Thank you, Doctor, but I think I know how to deal with one tin robot." Well, that guy, he just completely ignores the Doctor's advice. Not only does he scoff at the Doctor's advice, but he completely ignores it by not going for the eye. God, idiot. It's not even a tin robot. It's an armored tank housing a mutant inside. Of course, the Doctor did tell Van Staten that. And this story is masterfully visually executed. The cinematography and the editing and the direction it's taking it in, just a masterpiece, and all the acting amazing. I especially love Van Staten's bit where he realizes the soldiers are dead when they stop shooting, and anything from Christopher Eccleston is Oscar worthy, or BAFTA worthy at the very least. It's just so good, and I love how they're trying to make the Daleks have a bit more of an emotion with the genetic taking some of Rota's genetics into the Dalek and absorbing it and taking the Doctor-Dalek relationship to a new level. This isn't just the Doctor and Dalek hating each other. This is the Doctor and Dalek despising each other following the events of the Time War and the Dalek experiencing changes thanks to absorbing DNA from Rose. This is a brand new take on the Doctor-Dalek relationship, and it's amazing. Robert Sherman, the writer of the story, took the basis of his Big Finish audio Jubilee, which is a fantastic audio, by the way, and pretty much wrote this story based on some of the ideas, such as the Doctor encountering the Dalek in the cage and the Dalek feeling emotions for the Doctor's companion. In this case, Rose, in Jubilee's case, Evelyn Smythe. I actually really loved those scenes in that story. And there's a lot of very similar stuff and similar lines between the two. The rest of the story is pretty different. It couldn't be any more different. But the basis of Jubilee has absorbed itself into Dalek. And I think the new take of that story lends itself spectacularly. And the television angle of this story is able to tell that story just as fantastically, if not more so, than the audio depiction of Jubilee's did. Dalek, like Jubilee, is a work of fucking genius. It is so awesome, it's so amazing, and just, it's so beautiful to look at. Some morals don't quite make sense, like the Doctor is being talked down not to kill the Dalek at the end, even though he has the right. Then again, it's the Doctor, so maybe we shouldn't have our heroes kill... or at least kill the villain at the very end, because it might not send a good message to the audience. But at the same time, it still works with the character, even if it goes against what he normally does. But I can see where he's coming from. But at the end of the day, Dalek is an outstanding story with superb writing and amazing execution, and the performances are top notch. So I will be giving Dalek a 10 out of 10. Yes, this story is just magnificent. This is just a magnificent story. Oh, so amazing. Wait a minute. This means that this is the first 10 out of 10 score for a new series episode. And how ironic or how appropriate that, like my first 10 out of 10 score for a Classic Who story, it's a Dalek story. With that one, it was for the chase. You know what this means? What? It's time to party!
I don't like partying!
Shut up and dance! Shut up and drive and dance, dance, dance!
Ah, help me!
No. I'm just singling that for fun. Anyway, that's it from me. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys next time for the long game, the next episode of the series. Goodbye. And before you ask, yes, Big Finish fans, I do consider Jubilee a 10 out of 10 story as well. Happy? Right, now that that's done, I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.
Halt!
When did you get here?
I have been here all this time. Now I will exterminate you. No, I have a better idea.
And what's that then?
You will review the long game. You will review the long game. You will review the long game.
Joke's on you. I'm doing that anyway. I just said so.
You know what? Screw this. I'm off. See you in the series finale.
Bye then. See you in Bad Wolf Parting of the Ways. Okay. Bye. Don't forget to click below to subscribe to the official Nicholas Payne Retro YouTube channel. Especially loved the Doctor. Doctor's. He's. Justice. Maybe the other early. Maybe the early to mid 70s Dalek. Well, besides the special weapons Dalek. And pretty much being a prisoner of private auction. And I think her final scene definitely reflects on her character at the very end when she takes. And I think such a great character. Yeah, she's a good character. Yeah, she's. She has a pretty good scene before she dies, so that's good. She has a pretty cool scene when she does. She has a pretty good. So, on the. And like I said, this store. And at the end of the day, Dalek is an outstanding story and is definitely an out. That in the end of was superb execution and outstanding. Right, goodbye. I'll see you guys next. Right, now that we're.
Halt! Oh, well, you know what? Forget this, you know.
Wait a minute. This is the first 10 out of 10 review. No.
You Look, I'm sorry to disturb you and everything. Mr. Van Staten might think he's clever, but never mind him. I've come to talk and review you. I'm Nicholas Payne, you may call me Nick. Let me out! Let me out! I've got unlocked it.
Stab it, you double pricks.
A fart and a da and a curtain not playing. Here we go.
Exterminate.
That's better.
Exterminate! You are a prisoner of the Daleks! You must be destroyed! Why is my voice not working?
Oh, I don't feel so good at the moment.
And it's outstanding!